What's going on, arcade nerds? Let me show you around. My wife insisted that we move a bunch of games, and so we did. Let me explain why. And plus, we got rid of some games, we brought in some games, we moved a bunch of things around, okay? But in this room over here, we were able to fit more games, more vectors, than in this room over here. So, my wife wanted to try to put more vectors together, and yet, 2 days later, we got another vector working, so now we still can't fit all the vectors in the vector room. But, let me go around and let me show you guys. This is like an update of what's going on with my arcade here. But, now, in the comments down below, tell me if you can figure out which games we took out of here. But, okay, we obviously have the Sega Vectors here. Tax Scan, Space Fury, Star Trek. Over here, we have Omega Race. Let me get this. Let me get this out of the way. That on the floor. This is the first Color Vectrex arcade ever made. As far as I know, it's the only one in the world. If you want to know how to do this, send me an email and I'll write you some schematics on how to do this. Tempest, of course. Gravatar. Soon I'm going to have a Lunar Battle. So I'm going to have to move Tempest probably out in the other room, and I'll have Lunar Battle here also. Lunar Battle, and okay, so Space Duel, Black Widow, of course, Quantum. Oh, look at these beautiful control panels. Major Havoc, of course. Star Wars and Star Wars Empire Strikes Back. But this is the kit, so you have to... Hold on. I put a switch in there. Okay, so now it's Empire Strikes Back. I need to get the artwork someday for this, so it says Empire Strikes Back. Of course, Battlezone, Red Baron, Lunar Lander, Asteroids, you gotta have Asteroids Deluxe. Now this has that hack I wrote. Right now it's playing Mini Asteroids. Armor Attack, War of the Worlds, and of course Star Castle, Solar Quest. You don't see those very often. Hi. oh, Rip Off. I stole the ribbon cable from Rip Off. So right now Rip Off does not work. There's a ribbon cable that connects the monitor to the board. I fixed Starhawk, so I got the ribbon cable. So basically, Starhawk I need to make another ribbon cable. I will. I'll probably do it tomorrow. High School Beer. It's not a vector, of course, but it fits here perfectly because there's a beam right here, and it kind of just fits right there. Yeah. So here's Tron. There's Journey. Here is Dodson 280 Zap. Really cool game. I actually changed the code on this so it swears when you crash. You know what? I'm going to show you real quick. If I can reach in. I'm going to just try to do a one-handed game here. It's, oh my god, you know, instead of... That one's original. That one's original. I'm trying to get a swear word, a cuss word. Oh, come on. Like, the one time it does not do a swear word. Shit! But, Q-Bert, of course. Mad Planets. I still never bought the paper bezel. I'm using a Galaga paper bezel in there. You know, Enigma 2 here. Of course, you gotta have Tapper. Beautiful Tapper. Tutankhamun. There's Journey. Liberator. Warlords. Donkey Kong, you gotta have Donkey Kong. Fix-It Felix Jr. Stargate, Joust 2, Robotron, Defender, Punch-Out. Now, let me tell you about my cliffhanger. My cliffhanger has all working boards and everything, but I didn't have the disc. Well, just recently, someone gave me a cliffhanger disc. So, as of right now, it's running, it's a thing they used to do before Dexter. You know what I mean? It's running off a computer. So, I'm going to actually put this back together, all original, with the real disc in the future here. Beautiful Berserk. Frenzy, of course. You know, a couple people made comments and saying, "Oh, geez, Jason, you're rich." And believe me, I'm not rich. I'm not rich, guys. I'm in financial trouble. A rich guy would have bought all this stuff working. My average game, I probably paid $300 for. You know, and I bought, okay, for example, everything I bought was broken. This Tempest did not work. Gravatar did not work. Didn't work. Did not work. Did not work. Did not work. Did not work. That did not work when I got it. That didn't work when I got it. That didn't work when I got it. That did work, but that was $300. That did not work. That definitely did not work. That definitely did not work. Star Castle did not work. Solar Quest was like a 4-year project. Well, I didn't work on it for 4 years, but it sat there forever. This, I had to build an entirely new cabinet. This cabinet was falling apart. It was a complete nightmare. That did not work. This definitely did not work. This is my own invention. Jeez, I mean, I got this from Lloyd. That did not work. This didn't work. This actually somewhat worked when I got it. iRobot. Oh, let me show you iRobot. That's kind of cool. That did not work. That's actually a combination of an iRobot and a Firefox, but it's all done. Twee Zap did not work. Oh yes, it did. It partially worked when I got it. It was close. Tron did not work. Journey was a complete conversion. I had to repair a board, find a board, and everything. This was converted to a basketball game. I had to convert it back. Q-Bert. Now this. When I got it, this worked, but the sound did not. And I'll tell you the story on it. A guy wanted a multicade real bad, and he had this really water-damaged Q-Bert, and it's mint now, but it was working without sound. So, you know, I had to build the guy a multicade just to get it, you know. Mad Planets did not work. Tapper I paid $75 for, brand new. It did not work either. You see a trend coming on here? You know, you're rich. This worked when I bought it. You're rich if you buy all this stuff working. Tutankhamun did not work. Journey did not work. Berserk was a combination of a working and a non-working Berserk. Frenzy did not work. Cliffhanger did not work. War of the Worlds worked. Warlords worked when I got it. Liberator did not work. And some of you guys are watching my channel, you actually know, because I bought them from you guys, you know. Punch-Out did work. I got a great deal on that. Defender worked. Robotron did not work. This guy worked. Joust 2. Stargate did not work. Fixed Felix is just some creation, you know what I mean? Donkey Kong did not work. So, I mean, you know, especially when I started buying this stuff, it was when games were cheaper. You know what I mean? Now everyone's got to put these big crazy price tags on, and I get it. I mean, there's a game I'm thinking about selling, I put the crazy price tag on it just to see if it'll happen. You know, but it seems like the people that really do have money are now shelling it out for some of these games, and whenever I sell a game, I like lose a piece of me. I really do. But yeah, so this is like a walkthrough. What do you guys think of the new setup in here? Slow children, you know? I like it. For some reason, this fan on these Sega Vectors, it's like blowing my beard back. This fan is so strong right now. Yeah, I don't know. What do you guys think about the new layout? I'll get this damn thing working again. I'll probably get a new ribbon cable pressed for it. But as you can tell, I love the Vectors. Oh, check out my lamp. That's actually three Tempest MathBox boards zip tied together, and it's like a lamp. Got the IBM 5151 right here. You know, a buddy of mine gave me this. This is, he had to scrap it. It was too far gone. A pole position cabinet. So he cut out the Atari and kept one for himself and gave one to me. Yeah. But yeah, sometimes I come down here, and I know it may sound crazy, but I'll just walk through here and enjoy the smell of these old games and wipe them down, and you know, I definitely got the bug here. You know what I mean? any of you collectors, you just go, wow, I'm so glad I got that. How did I get that? A lot of games, I thought, I'm never getting it. I'll never get a Q-Bert. Because when I got my Q-Bert, Q-Berts were $2,000. Nope, never getting one. I'm never able to afford it. I ended up spending one day, a junk cabinet, and a 61 board for it. You know what I mean? You know, or like this. I went to an operator's warehouse with this tapper. Paid $75. For this tapper, okay? I just went to an operator's warehouse, and he had like a loft, and I said, hey, what do you want for those games up top? And he says, oh, $75 for any junk cabinet you find. And there's like a mint tapper cabinet that had not turned green yet. Excellent condition, missing the board. And I paid $75. And you know, Tutankhamun, this was a total train wreck. This was converted to a football game. I forget what game it is. You might know when I tell you this. It had football, like joystick tops. The tops looked like footballs. Leave a comment if you know what game that was. But I happen to have another buddy who used to be an operator years ago, and he had a garage filled with junk. And I got a new old stock Tutankhamun marquee, a new old stock control panel, and I just found some random Wickos and put that together. But, yeah. This was an expensive project for me. My buddy Jeff from Arcade Hollywood, he gave me the side art. He bought Brandy's side art, and he decided not to use it because his looked, on his journey, it looked pretty good already. But, I mean, expensive project for me is, yeah, I had to buy the bezel. That was expensive. I had to buy the marquee. That was expensive. And the overlay. You know, I'm not made of money. But as you can see, my Frenzy does not have a Frenzy bezel. It has a Berserk bezel. Now, here's a quiz for you. Did you know Cliffhanger was actually based on a Japanese cartoon? It was called... I forget what it's called, but I have it in the frame right here. What was it called? It's in the back of my mind. Normally, I tell you anytime. But here, let me show you this. I have, I'm kind of proud of my little autograph stuff. You know, I'm trying to collect autographs on stuff. And I got Joel West's autograph on my Berserk. Joel West's autograph on my Frenzy. Gary Stern signed my Frenzy and my Berserk. And Gary Stern also signed my Tutankham. World record holder, Austin, he's a young kid. He signed my my Mad Plants. He has the world record for this game. Who else signed what? Oh, Eugene Jarvis signed my Defender, of course. Eugene Jarvis signed my Robotron. What else? I forget the guy's name. David something or other. Whether he is or he used to be, he signed my Fix-It Felix Jr. He was the world record holder. A whole bunch of nerds signed my Donkey Kong, Billy Mitchell, Walter Day, whatever. I'll tell you what, just recently I got those Warlords and I wanted this game forever. And I specifically wanted the upright. Wanted it bad. And it ended up being a decent machine. Not too bad. Who else signed what? I don't know. Richie Knuckles, he signed my, I don't know if you can see that. He signed my Space Fury. Is that it? I don't know. I mean, I got a Pac-Man and stuff like that that was signed, but, you know, it's out in the garage. I don't have all my games in here. I wish I had the room to put my games in here, you know? What do you call it? John Salter, he's a world record holder for Armor Attack. He signed my Armor Attack. Oh, and I think, yeah, he did sign my my Tron also. That was pretty cool. Now, he is not the world record holder for Tron as of right now. He intends to. He says he's practicing. He's going to do it. Let's see if I can find it. We'll see. I don't know. But, did he? Oh, yeah, he did. Okay. He is the second highest score in Tron, and he says that he can do it, so we'll see what happens. But either way, you know, this is the kind of stuff. By the way, I have games upstairs, and I don't know if I want to show you because my wife will be mad at me because the room upstairs, kind of turned into where all the clothes go. So there's a humongous pile of clothes in the middle of the arcade room. So if I show you, my wife will be mad. she's all worried. She doesn't want to be on camera. She's worried about people seeing her and judging her. You know what? I don't care. You can judge me if you want. I'm a big fat guy. I know. I don't know. You guys that may have already seen this channel, you know what? Yeah, I know. You probably already seen all this crap, but, you know, I looked on YouTube, and there really wasn't too many, arcade tour videos. And, you know, I figured I'd put mine out there again, you know? But, okay, if you guys like what I do, if you guys like my crap, if you guys like to see old games, I do that stuff on this channel. So, have a good one. Please subscribe, and, have a nice day.